Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Follow the Twitter, follow the Twitch, and let's just jump into the video. Let's Talk Jinx, a weekly Jinx video we do every Wednesday about anything to do with Jinx, as well as this video acting as a weekly discussion thread on the Jinx subreddit, our League of Jinx. Make sure to go check that out. And every 2 weeks when a new patch hits, we talk about that patch, changes on the patch that might affect Jinx, other AD carries, and then something of a pseudo AD carry tier list to round the video out with your input included based off of your elo. Make sure to comment about your own thoughts about what should and shouldn't be banned and stuff like that based off the changes we see in the patch itself. And so we're going to start, of course, by going over patch 9.12, in which case there were no direct changes to Jinx, but there were some other changes to some other AD carries in the form of Ashe and Caitlyn. With Ashe, the W cooldown is being decreased actually, because with Ashe, they want to give Ashe more power. They say Ashe could use more power, so they're specifically buffing the ability that she uses the most to keep enemies at bay. And in laning phase, it depends if like they're going for like the W max in lane phase possibly. When it comes to like the Jinx-Ashe matchup, what might change here then is like more harassing power because the cooldown is decreased. So the ability will be up more often for you to get hit by. Obviously, one of the best ways to counter this ability is just to stand in the minion wave if you can. Not at the very front of it, because there is like 5 arrows flying out, so you do want as many minions to take the hits as possible. So you can use them to kind of block this ability for the most part. But just be aware, like, it will be up more often in Ashe as someone who does possibly build Essence Reaver, especially now that it's been buffed. They don't really have to worry about spamming it too much and running out of mana, because they might be rushing that item and just have more mana and stuff later anyways, especially as the lane phase goes on. That's just something to keep in mind. They might not max this ability, of course, for like the harass and stuff. They might still go Q max, and in which case the ability won't actually be up that often in laning phase, so the matchup won't really probably change, but like mid to late game might be something you might have to worry about. Caitlyn is the other one. The good old Hat Lady herself is actually getting buffed as well. The base attack damage is increased. This is definitely a small buff, they say, but we're being extra cautious with her since she has a tendency to overtake metas. Cough, season 7, cough. So the base stats, basically her attack damage is going up from 58 to 60. Basically, one of two things are going to happen, both in the Jinx-Caitlyn matchup and then really in the anything-Caitlyn matchup. Basically, one, last hitting is going to get like a little bit easier because the base damage is now back up to 60. There was a time where a lot of AD carries, though, attack damage was up pretty high before the marksman, I believe, rework dropped them all, and then like 811 dropped them all like down to like the low 50s or like mid 50s. But anyways, so she'll be able to last hit. So even if she can't really beat you, she might be able to last hit better and as such get her items just through gold that way. Be aware of that. And then also in trading potential, right? Especially with the headshot procs and stuff. It's going to be like a little bit more damage on there. And I know people tend to laugh at like 3 AD and stuff like that, but when it comes to like AD champions, auto attacks and stuff, that can be very good in the early game to try and help you get going until you get to those items that kind of just really crit and then do all that damage for you anyways. And then there you go, right? So those are really the two main AD carry changes that you want to kind of be worried about. Well, maybe not worried about, but that might affect the, like the Jinx matchup with those champions because of the changes happening to them. Outside of AD carries, we do have some support changes, right? We have like the Yuumi changes, where the base health has been increased, the passive mana refund decreased early, the shield decreased, the W shared adaptive force adjusted, dash now interruptible by all CC. Basically, Yuumi's actually a pretty good champion after all, and so good Yuumis are very frustrating to play against and have virtually no windows of vulnerability, and more players are starting to get good at Yuumi. So with this in mind, we're pulling some of the mid-patch buffs we gave her at release and nerfing her defenses to open up some weaknesses, also bug fixes and usability improvements. So how do you feel about going either against Yuumi as Jinx or just AD carries period, or playing with the Yuumi? This might be a bit of changes that, like, if you really don't like playing against this champion, you're one of those people that are like, I really don't, this makes it really hard to kill my lane opponent, maybe it might open up some more weaknesses there. And if you're someone that likes playing with this champion or even doesn't like playing with this champion, maybe that gets a bit more frustrating then, because they're not going to be as powerful as they currently have been. In terms of other supports, we do have a Karma change where the Q slow is increased, the E cost is decreased, movement speed duration increased to match shield duration. We're giving Karma more tools to help her survive, especially when she's caught out by herself. Basically, like if Karma goes to ward, like to roam and to ward by herself, right? If she tries to face check or something, is why tanks are so popular in the pro play scene, at least in my opinion, right? They can go face check a brush or something when they go to ward, and they probably won't get blown up immediately because they're kind of tanky. Some like mages and stuff, why they could be good, they can't really maybe do that, but this might help Karma be able to do that at least a little bit, and then also maybe help her just in general be a more, like, I don't want to say supportive champion, but like with the E up and stuff like that, maybe you can do some more things there with Karma to bring her a little bit into the meta, right? There are going to be some champions that might want that protection or just want a Karma on their team, and then Karma herself can also do more stuff as well that might bring her value to a team composition. Lulu is actually just getting all of her, you know, visual effects updated. The E shield increase, cost decrease later as well. So they did slide in a change as well. Lulu with like a Jinx or like a hyper carry is usually pretty good, but Lulu's kind of been in the spot ever since the 812 changes to shields and heals that it did to support. So I don't actually know where people have Lulu there, but just keep that in mind. That is a change that is happening. That also goes hand in hand with a Nautilus nerf this patch, with a Q base damage decreased early. So they're reducing Nautilus' early all-in damage, since he's currently too strong in high areas of play. Most people would argue he's just kind of just strong as a support pick, even in low, you know, areas of play. He's just kind of a good go-to support right now, if you're auto-filled or just anything, right? He's a good CC bot. Maybe this will make him a little bit less damaging with his all-ins, give you the chance to at least flash away or heal or something, instead of maybe being chained CC to death. Maybe not, and who knows, but maybe that will help a little bit. And that's kind of really all for the changes happening directly to AD carries, none to Jinx again, and of course some do some supports that might either make laning against those supports a bit more frustrating or not frustrating, or better if you're playing with them. Now, what we tend to do, we kind of used to do this long-winded thing. Based off of feedback, we kind of just go to champion.gg for this next section as we head into the tier list. Now, again, your input's going to be important, because as we go over these changes, with champion.gg, for example, this is dealing with Plat Plus. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the changes we just went over and apply them to like win rates and stuff now, because obviously by the time this video comes out, the patch will just be starting. We don't actually have data to look back on for the patch. So what we tend to do is take the changes, apply them to where we see champions are now heading into the patch, to kind of try and predict where they're going to end up. So first, we'll just address the fact that according to this site, Jinx is back on top of being like the best AD carry at a 53% win rate, almost a 54, which is kind of interesting because she was like just at a 52 in the last video, like just 2 weeks ago. Sivir and Kog'Maw right up there with her in like the top three, with Ashe and Xayah rounding up the top five. A lot of Essence Reaver AD carries actually doing pretty well. Twitch is up there actually, as a matter of fact, if we're going with like the top 10, like Misfortune, Draven. Jhin and Vayne round up the top 10, even though they're sub 50, and then things like Kai'Sa, Caitlyn, etc. They're kind of a bit a ways low actually. So there we go, in terms of just talking about where the champions stand heading into the patch. Now, going over the changes that we were just talking about, right? Like, Ashe might move up because maybe she can bully a bit more in lane with the W and stuff like that. Or just because across the game, out of laning phase, as the game goes on, right? Like, she'll be able to use that a bit more often to slow people, kite people, maybe make it a little bit harder to kill her when there's also maybe a Karma and Lulu on her team. Those are, but you know, they got, I guess, changes at least, if nothing else, so they're going to be around. A Nautilus with his all-ins are going to be a little bit less if he's playing against this champion, but if he's with this champion, that could be both a pro or con, but it's going to be a lot of CC with her arrow and stuff, so maybe not for like an Ashe specifically. Now, Caitlyn, meanwhile, who's sitting at a sub 50% win rate going into this patch, again, being able to farm better if nothing else, if even without the trading better and like the extra damage with the items and the headshot procs, right? Just being able to maybe farm better and last hit better with that extra AD might mean she gets the gold income better and gets her items better and faster. And that might bump her up a little bit just because she'll be like more, I don't want to say like reliable AD carry, but like, she'll be just stronger if that's going to be a thing that happens, right? So she might bump up at least to like a 50% win rate, but honestly, that wouldn't really change or shake up the entire like ADC meta all that much, right? Like, we don't really see Jinx in pro play right now. Pro play has started, but of the AD carries we do see in pro play that kind of are on this list, right? We see the Sivirs and the Xayahs and stuff like that. Would that be enough to bump Ashe into more of a pro play prominence? I don't necessarily think so, but in terms of like a general AD carry tier list, basically you can still stick with like Jinx, Kog'Maw, Sivir, Ashe, and Xayah as like your top five. Of course, the Ashe changes might mix her around a little bit with like Sivir, possibly. Sivir's a really good AD carry though, actually, right now. Even though she's not number one here and it's actually Jinx, Sivir is probably one of the best AD carries you can play, actually, period, in terms of like, you know, if you want to talk like S tier, right? Because she can shove indefinitely, she can poke with like the boomerang, I guess, harass and stuff like that. Even with her short range, things like Caitlyn and Jinx, who should be able to bully her, Sivir's actually really good in the most AD carries right now because of that. So if you, especially if you're auto-filled or something, and like you can't play Ezreal, because that's like the, really the auto-filled AD carry, Sivir's probably like one of your next best picks, actually, if we're not looking at these numbers and just talking in general in terms of like the meta, what, you know, we've seen people playing both in pro and in solo queue and stuff like that. But beyond that, right, we have the Jinxes, and like Caitlyn can counter Sivir a little bit, and these changes might help her become a Sivir counter. So I don't want to sell Sivir too hard to you as like an S tier champion, because Caitlyn kind of has historically been something of a lane counter to her, and these changes might make Caitlyn more of a counter and actually keep Sivir in place, and as such make Caitlyn more of a priority, because Caitlyn in pro play has been a bit more of a priority, at least in North America recently and lately. So you, we might actually see that happen there too. So just like and this is, I'll just give my opinion, how about that, but just, this is an actual factual AD carry tier list. It's just based off of me, off of the data we've seen from pro play and stuff like that, right? We've seen a lot of Sivir. We've seen Caitlyn possibly come up already, and now she might be even better against Sivir. So those actually might be like two actual like top tier AD carries you might want to go for if you're already an AD carry player. Again, the auto AD carry is Ezreal, even though his win rate is terrible. But just in general, right, we see like Jinx, Kog'Maw, Xayah, Twitch, Misfortune, things that really aren't getting changed and nothing that's happening that will affect them, except like if they get bullied heavily by Caitlyn, if they can't match her like with her range or pound for pound. Jinx kind of can, so you know, she can still stay up there and stuff like that. But that's kind of what I mean by your opinion as we get to the end of the video. Going over these changes, what I've discussed, the changes we go know about heading into this patch, what do you think will be like the best AD carries? Comment in the comment section down below so when someone watches this video, they can go down in the comments and be like, here's a tier list that actually applies to me because this person's commenting from like Platinum, for example, and I'm in Platinum, so there we go. Or this person's Diamond and I'm in Diamond. Or this person's in Silver and I'm in Silver. So I can read that, see that, and be like, yes, this is the one that kind of applies to me. I'm kind of giving general stats so people can kind of form their own opinions. But thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification, the actual subscribe button. But I don't know which video will be next because life can have a lot of kinks. So until next time, take care. GG get jinxed. Thank you for watching and enjoy pizza responsibly.